wife, to all of the saints in the building. Thank God tonight that I'm saved and I'm sanctified. I'm baptized and filled with the Holy Ghost. And that's with fire. I don't have any problem giving praise. I don't have a problem opening my mouth. I can do it. Because I know what God is and I know what God has done. Praise God. Hallelujah. I thank God. I know this is just a little 10-minute bit, but my daughter is here tonight. I asked her to come and she said, I'm coming. So she's here. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. The Lord has been moving mightily in this place. Praise God. As we move on in the year, we're nearing the end of the year. The Lord brought back to me what the pastor said. And for the past 3 or 4 months, I've constantly been saying it to myself. And the Lord reminds me of what he said, that I will not deal with the things this year that I dealt with last year. I will be an overcomer. Is that right?
Amen.
Are we overcomers?
Amen.
Do we remember what we shouted about?
Amen.
Do we remember how we confronted in the spirit?
Yes.
And we ran around the church?
Yes.
Or did we fall off a little bit?
Right.
When trials come,
yes.
When they came, what did we do? Did we give up? God is calling us to bring forth. Every ministry, when it starts out with a marvelous testimony. We hear about the good things, how God got us going, how we prayed. I've heard you talk about how God just blessed you. But it's in the middle that we have a little struggle. I sense we're in the middle of something here. Season of birth. God changed my message. Praise God, from Sunday to yesterday morning. Praise God. Praise God. I'm in Luke 1. And I'm going to talk to you about a season of birth. Purpose and destiny. Some of the speakers I already have talked to you about the process. But I said, Lord, I don't think we quite understand what's going on the inside. When it feels when you're moving, if you don't have the Holy Ghost in it, I suggest that perhaps that's the Holy Ghost drawing you a little closer, because God wants to fill you. We in an hour and a day where we need the power of the Holy Ghost. It takes the Holy Ghost to keep us. It takes the Holy Ghost to guide us. It takes the Holy Ghost to give us boldness to stand in the midst of. Around me. When I'm on my knees, I get a different sense in the temple praying. It's a sad thing to operate in a position and do it over and over without a godliness sense. Praise God, becomes a routine to you. We're coming to church every Sunday. We shout to have a good time. It just becomes a thing that we do. Hey, my God, I come to choir rehearsal here. I sing in the choir. I minister. I'm a part of it, but what's going on the inside of you? What are you bringing forth when you come to the choir? What are you? What's coming out of you? It ought to be some anointing by now. It ought to be something going on by now. We ought to see some manifestation of the Spirit of God in your life. And in the church. Because when it jumps in your belly, it'll jump in yours. When it jumps in my belly, it'll jump in yours. We got the same Holy Ghost, but it ought to quicken something in your body. My God. Yes, God. I know Zechariah hadn't heard a word in a long time. Been over 400 years, hadn't heard a word. So I can understand that he was surprised. I can understand that. I can make an excuse for him. He was a man of God, but I have to make an excuse for him. Lord, they hadn't heard a word. But when he heard the word, he didn't believe it. He had been praying. Why are we praying if we don't believe God?
All right.
My God, it's just a waste of time, is it not? If we don't believe God. But this was the beginning of the church. Look how marvelous John the Baptist came to me. His parents was old and of age. Who would have thought at this age that you would birth a son? But then there's Mary on the other hand. Sweet the Lord, young girl. I love you. That zeal in you. You ain't thought about no consequences. You just said yes. Remember the day when God sanctified us. When it burned on the inside of us. When we were so glad to get to church. We just running all over the place. Whenever you say yes, God. We was ready. We wanted to do it. That zeal. You don't know yet, but what I like about this young lady is that it did not matter. She meant her yes. No matter what the cost was, she meant her yes. She may not have had the full understanding of where she was going. Because, sister, you're going to be humiliated. You're going to be cast aside. You're going to be talked about. You're going to almost lose your man, but God had already stepped in and set it all up. My God. So she gets up and runs to her cousin. And the news, just the news of it, made the baby leap in the womb. Do you know you got something in you that we need? You got something in you that the body of Christ needs. The ministry cannot grow until we learn how to go forth and go through and deliver what God has deposited in you. We have intercessors in this house. We got people who can hear. Sister T, we know when God is doing something in her because she don't mind hitting that floor.
I know.
back when. Uh-huh. Sparkle of life in us. Uh-huh. Nothing wrong with that. Yeah. Look at Mary. Sweet thing. Spoke to this lady. She was filled with the Holy Ghost and the baby on the inside of her. So we know the story. I'm not going to go there, but I'm going to shift you a little bit. We're going to go past the disciples and how Jesus had dealt with all the work he'd done. He had designated power, and the disciples had done the work. St. John 16 chapter, he starts to prepare them for his leaving. Do you know that was another shift in the church? This time there was a spiritual shift. You got a birth so we can go to the next level. Whatever God's depositing in you, when he's been drawing you to your knees, you got to get on your knees. You got to shut your phone off. You got to make time to talk with him. Just a little while. It's something about the Holy Ghost till you lose yourself in time. You don't even realize you've been there so long. My God. My God. Jesus began to talk to him and tell him, listen, I got to get you ready because I got to go. They're going to kill you. They're going to put you out of the synagogues. Look at what we're facing today. My God, where is the spirit of discernment? These people walking in these churches. Nobody knows what's going on until somebody gets a sheep. God forbid we sit here with the gift of the Holy Ghost and somebody don't have the discernment of the spirit. You better lose it. You better let go and let God do a mighty work in you.
Where is it? Yeah.
Praise God.
Yeah.
The next step was to go and tarry.
Uh-huh.
I love my pastor because we don't have tarry service the old time way like we used to. But what he does is when the Spirit of the Lord is in the house, he'll just let you go ahead on with it. We can make that tarry service.
Yes. Yes.
When you're ready.
Yes.
When you have a ready heart.
Right.
It really doesn't matter. Do you hear me?
Yes.
God fills you with a ready heart.
Yes.
Do you hear me?
Yes.
If you're wounded, don't stop until you get everything God's got for you.
Yes.
There's healing in the word. There's healing.
Yes.
God wanna do a thing in this ministry.
Yes. Yes. Thank you, Jesus.
He wants to do it in this ministry. God wants to get us ready. So they went on to the next step. When the Holy Ghost came, well, that was the spiritual birth. The Holy Ghost is here now. We ain't got no excuse. You can call it anything you want, but when I get the power of God, he's already told me that he's going to lead me to all truth. He don't even tell me what to say when I don't even know what to say.
Yes.
Tell me now.
Yes.
I wouldn't stop if I were you.
Yes.
Until I got the fullness.
Yes.
Of Christ.
Yes.
Until I got the indwelling of the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
Oh my God. Yes. My God. You can't make it. You can't make it without me.
Yes.
You can't make it without the Holy
Yes.
Ghost.
Yes.
Everything God's got in you.
Yes.
The connection. The Holy Ghost.
Yes.
The Holy Ghost is like an umbilical cord.
Yes.
He's right there. He tells the Father everything I need.
Yes.
Even when I can't speak the words.
Yes.
In my groaning.
Yes.
The Holy Ghost making intercession.
Yes.
For me.
Yes.
Don't walk to the right doors.
Yes, come.
Stand still.
Yes.
Don't go to the left. Until every soul on the back page runs to this altar and declare, I want to be.